gospel today, as almost every gospel is a call to universal and unequivocal compassion. The life of Christ and his teachings are about doing good and being kind and bringing light into dark places. In the beginning, Christianity was known as a religion of love. The Emperor Hadrian, looking for a reason to outlaw the new religion, asked for a report from one of his officials by the name of Aristides. And here is what Aristides wrote to him about Christianity. I quote, "Christians love one another. They never fail to help widows. They save orphans from those who would hurt them. If a man has something, he gives freely to the one who has nothing. If they see a stranger, Christians take him home and are happy as though he were a real brother. They don't consider themselves brothers in the usual sense, but brothers instead through the Spirit of God. And if they hear that one of them is in jail or persecuted for professing the name of their Redeemer, they give him all that he needs. If it is possible, they bail him out. If one of them is poor and there isn't enough food to go around, they fast for several days to give him the food he needs. This is really a new kind of person. There is something divine in them." End quote. Hadrian chose to adopt a policy towards Christianity, unlike the other emperors, that was largely indifferent. At least he didn't persecute and kill them. "Christians love one another," wrote Aristides, "and also extended their love to strangers, following the example of the Lord. Jesus healed Samaritans, after all, and broke every law and social restriction that stood in the way of compassion. Today, I fear many Christians demonstrate the opposite attitude and then wonder why we are not respected in the larger society. It is not rocket science. Respect begets respect. Love begets love, and judgment begets more judgment. If we are persecuted for being judgmental and ugly towards others, who's to blame? And when we act hatefully toward anyone, we cannot expect warm and fuzzy feelings to ensue towards us. Our faith calls us to acknowledge the sacredness of all human beings, and indeed of all creation, without condition. St. Paul writes in 1 Corinthians that we must do everything out of love. St. James tells us that we must not be respecters of persons. That is, extending compassion to some and not towards others. Doing anything else is a betrayal of Christ, the Church, our neighbors, and ourselves. An example of this, a great example, is the behavior of our church in Lebanon, that unlike other religious groups, has no militia, choosing the way of peace, and whose charitable organizations do not reject people of any sect or religion, even during times of civil war. In the gospel reading today, Jesus does not make mention of the heretical beliefs of the Samaritans when he tells the former leper, who was a Samaritan, "Your faith has made you well." Faith and belief are not the same thing. The Roman priest Richard Rohr comments that we often have worshipped Jesus and yet have not followed him, making of Christianity a religion rather than a way of life. He further writes these insightful words, and I quote, "Christians are usually sincere and well-intentioned until you get to any real issues of ego, control, power, money, pleasure, and security. Then they tend to be pretty much like everybody else. We are often given a bogus version of the gospel, some fast food religion without any deep transformation of the self. And the result has been the spiritual disaster of Christian countries that tend to be consumer-oriented, proud, warlike, racist, class-conscious, and addictive, like everybody else. You and I must be better than this. We must allow the gospel to transform us from the inside out, not just our behavior, but our very essence. It is the gospel that must motivate us and be our reason, our guide, our method, and our way of life. We must practice being like Christ, practicing love, practicing peace, practicing kindness, and practicing egolessness. These are not the goal of the Christian life. They are the way of the Christian life. For if we believe in Him, we will not only worship Him, we will follow Him and do as He did and obey His commandments. And this path leads directly to universal, non-judgmental, and unconditional compassion. Remembering that all men and women are our brothers and sisters, and that each one is fighting a great battle, let us approach one another with care, laying aside fear and suspicion, for the suspicious mind is always a sick mind. And let us consider how we might reduce the amount of suffering in this world, rather than increase it, and weep with those who weep, and laugh with those who laugh, and give without restraint, expecting nothing in return. I believe Christ's mission was to deliver us and everyone from this pain. And this is done not through avoidance, but through radical acceptance. Faith is not for the overcoming of obstacles. It is for experiencing obstacles all the way through. Christians who follow Christ dare to consciously live like He lived. Live in truth and love for all people. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.